Hey, what's up guys, Darkbreaker here and welcome to my Kaisa guide. In today's video we are going to talk about the best item build, runes and spells for Kaisa. First item is going to be Blade of the Rune King. It's going to grant you attack damage, attack speed, and in combination with Infinity Edge you will unlock the evolution of your first ability so you can upgrade it. And it's one of the best core items for ADC, especially thanks to the physical vamp and the bonus passive, which is going to slow the opponent, and then Infinity Edge. Second best core item for almost every ADC, going to give you attack damage, critical chance, and also increases critical strikes by 30%. So that's big. And those two items are definitely core items for almost every ADC. Next item is going to be Rune and Serican, going to grant you 25% critical rate and also attack speed. So in combination with Blade of the Rune King, you will have enough attack speed to also upgrade your third ability, which is going to a huge power boost for Kaisa. You can also go for Rapid Fire Cannon, or for Phantom Dance. Those two are also good options. Like I can show you right here, Phantom Dancer is going to give you attack speed, Rapid Fire Cannon also attack speed and crit chance. But Runen has great synergy with your S1. So with the S1 you do a lot of splash damage, and with Runens you will do even more splash damage. But Rapid Fire Cannon and Phantom Dancer are of course great crit chance items with attack speed for Kaisa. So those two are other options that you might go as the fifth item. Instead of Guardian Angel, you could go for those two items. But I like to have more sustain, more survivability. That's why I like to go for Guardian Angel, for the revive and giving my teammates more time to survive. Last item, of course, Mortal Reminder, giving you that armor penetration in the late game against tanks is really important, so you can shred through the armor of tanks and manage to kill them. And yeah, besides that, the first two items are definitely core item. Rune and Serican is really important, but the other options are Rapid Fire Cannon or Phantom Dancer, also great options for Kaisa. But I think that's the most typical build. Enchantments, Quicksilver Enchant, going to remove crowd control. You can also go for Stasis Enchant, which is going to give you the invulnerability so you can't get targeted. For the runes, of course Conqueror, one of the best runes. And then I like to go Gathering Storm or Champion. Those two are great options for ADCs. One is more scaling, the other one is really good in the early game. Champion really, really good in the early game, and if you don't die it's great in the late game as well. But I think Gathering Storm is the better option for beginners, so you can try to scale, and if you know you can play safe and you won't die a lot, then I definitely recommend Champion. One of the best runes in the game, Champion, definitely. 10% damage in the early game if you don't die, also in the late game. But Gathering Storm, great, great item to scale, and if you know that you will die most likely, because ADCs are always getting focused, you have a mark on your head, everyone wants to focus you, so maybe just go for Adaptive. And next one is going to be Hunter's Titan or Loyalty. Both are great options. Loyalty for the early game helps you out and also your teammate to get more armor and magic resistance. But another option, just Hunter's Titan, if you know that where you fight a lot, you will get a lot of kills and kill participations. You can easily stack up Hunter's Titan or go for Spirit Walker, which is probably the more safer option, not the snowball variation. Hunter's Titan, if you know, you will get a lot of kills. And Sweet Tooth is going to improve your early game. Big fan of Sweet Tooth, especially on champions that are not the strongest in the early game. So if you're getting poked, you have the Sweet Tooth. For the spells, it's pretty straightforward. You want to have flash no matter what, and then your other two options are going to be barrier or heal, depending on your support. Sometimes your support goes heal, then you go for barrier, because double heal doesn't stack up. And if they go for exhaust, for example, because they want to cock block Cannon's ultimate, then you can go for heal, so heal exhaust or barrier heal. Anyways, let's talk about the abilities. Kaiser's passive is going to mark the opponent with plasma, and after 5 hits it's going to proc and do additional damage. Also, your teammates can mark the opponents with plasma by applying CC onto the opponent. First ability does splash damage, as you guys can see right here. You can splash onto the opponent, and if you have enough AD you can level it up to increase the amount of attacks hitting the opponents. Second skill is a long range plasma shot, which is going to mark the opponents and also reveal them. And if you level it up, it will mark them with 3 plasma, so you can easier proc your passive and also resetting the cooldown by 80%. Next one is going to be the third ability. It's going to grant you movement speed and attack speed, and if you evolve it or power it up, then you will get invisible when you use it. And whenever someone has the plasma mark, you can use your ultimate to dash towards targets that have the plasma. So that's really nice. And yeah, it's really important to get those items to evolve your abilities. Anyways, let's hop right into the gameplay. So we have Corki mid lane, Wukong top lane, Master Yi jungle, and Lulu. Lulu, pretty nice support, one of the most broken supports in the game. So let's see how the game goes. I will just ward right here so we have some extra vision if someone is trying to invade. They put a ward in the bush as well. And right here, I forgot to pull for my Master Yi. So that's my bad. Usually you want to pull for your jungler. I don't know, I was not paying attention, but definitely, usually you want to pull for your teammate. And right, I'm just writing, oops, my bad, because I totally forgot to pull for him. Probably got distracted somehow, so I forgot it. But yeah, always pull. It's going to increase the jungle clear speed of your jungler, and maybe you can do a 4 camp into Scuttle because of that, and it's a big advantage if you can go for quicker or safer Scuttle, so you can at least secure one Scuttle. So that's why it's really important that you usually try to pull for your jungler. First blood from Wukong, well played. I think this lane is kind of annoying because Draven, Sona are pretty strong in the early game, so we have to play it kind of safe. And Kaiser is one of those champions that rely on getting items for the power spike. First power spike is after Blade of the Ruined King and BF Sword. You will have enough AD to upgrade your first ability, and then the next power spike is going to be when you have Rune and Hurricane. You will have enough attack speed to upgrade your third ability, which is going to give you more attack speed, movement speed, and also invincibility when you use your third ability. So, 3 items core spike for Kaiser basically. Okay, let's see if we can poke damage onto this Draven. He is pretty overextended, to be honest. And right now he's taking a lot of poke, and somehow we managed to burst him, surprisingly. I didn't expect that one, to be honest. But I guess Lulu hit her combo really well and did a lot of damage. Okay, let's reset. Get Lifesteal and the bow for more attack speed. Okay, if you pay attention to the minimap, we can see that Vi is at the top side right now, so we know no one is going to gank us anytime soon. Maybe the mid laner, but I doubt. It's not going to be risky. Like, Vi gank is pretty risky for us because of the ultimate. She can CC us, so that's kind of risky. But Orianna is pretty easy to avoid. You just need to not get hit by the ultimate, to be honest. Okay, right here, doing decent amount of poke, and actually his auto-attacks hurt like crazy! His auto-attacks hurt a lot, we took way too much damage right there. So, to be honest, bad trading on our part. 2 versus 1 and we took way too much damage. And if you have to play safe in the lane, you want to use your second ability to maybe get a few last hits. But I think the first ability is really great for securing last hits in the laning phase at least. Okay, nice, another solo kill by Wukong. Well played. We're going to mark them. We are kinda low life for Dragon right now, so if the enemy jungler is smart, he would just straight up rush it. He would say, oh, the bot lane is backporting, let's rush Dragon really quick, go go guys. But I think they are not rushing it, so we are fine. Okay, Yi jumped over the wall, he tries to go for it already. I think that's too ambitious on his part. He should wait for us to clear the wave and then we can join and help him. See what we can do here. Maybe I can poke them. Do I hit it? I don't hit it quite yet. Okay, let's jump in. Go for Draven. Let's go for Draven. Let's kill him. Come on. Die. Flash auto deck. We get him. Let's go. And let's see what we can do here. Okay, they're pretty low. I think we can just go for Dragon, to be honest. They're backporting. We have a huge wave. I think I can even go... I poked her. Wait, maybe I can kill Sona and then go for the turret. Okay, my Q. And we actually get the kill. I think I would just focus for... Yeah, I would just focus the turret. I think usually turret is always better than Dragon unless it's the Inferno. So securing the... First turret, okay, never mind. Tryndamere got the first turret, so no bonus first turret gold. But we will be able to get the second turret, which is going to give us global gold for the whole team. And we still managed to get the turret, the dragon, so that's not too bad. But usually you always want to go for the turret before dragon. Unless it's Inferno Dragon, then obviously go rush the Inferno. Oh my god, please, please, why? Let us escape. Let's go. It was I thought she still had ultimate and would kill us right here. That was clutch, to be honest. I didn't expect her to still sit there. Okay, getting BF sword and we should be able to level up our first ability. Or evolve our first ability. Which is going to increase the amount of plasma shots we are going to shoot with the first ability. Next dragon is going to be... Inferno Dragon in 3 minutes, so that's going to be important. Okay, going to clear the wave. And maybe we should rotate for the Herald. Because the Herald already spawned. And actually... Bot wave is going to come soon, so maybe we should just go back to bot, clear mid wave and then go bot lane, or maybe help for Herald, I'm not sure yet. Like if this was like a more competitive game, then the solo laner would go bot lane right now, and the bot lane would go for Herald, but since this is solo queue, it's like more Fiesta style. Okay, he's going to die, that was too deep for him. We're going to jump in, follow, we get the kill, nice. We do a lot of damage onto Orianna, maybe we can kill her, she is super low life. Going to poke her with my Q. She's almost dead actually, that's so unfortunate. I didn't expect my auto attacks to do so much damage. Do I help or do I go bot lane? Yeah, I think I just go bot lane and keep farming. Like, helping your teammates in fights is important, but you should always, as an ADC, focus on getting your items, especially on Kai'Sa. Focus on farming, getting your items. Don't join every fight which is going to end up in the Clown Fiesta. Maybe just focus on farming. A lot of times it's going to be better than just fighting here, fighting there, fighting here, fighting there, blah blah, Clown Fiesta, Clown Fiesta, Clown Fiesta. Just focus on farming, getting your gold items. It's better. Unless you're sure you're going to win, then of course come, but usually it's safer to just always secure your waves, push the wave deep in, and then you can roam. But if you roam too quickly or too early, then maybe the opponent will just punish you by pushing while you're fighting. So always shove in your waves before you try to roam anywhere. So that's why I'm going to shove the next wave and then I can roam. Shove the next wave and see whether or not we can go for the mid lane or for... Okay, Herald is gone now because no one wanted to the Herald. But Inferno Dragon is going to spawn in 30 seconds, so this one is going to be super important. Inferno Dragon, no matter what you want to contest the Inferno Dragon, is going to grant 8% bonus damage for the entire team. So no matter what, shove the waves in, get your items, but come for the dragon in time. Don't backport right before the dragon and don't take too much damage before the dragon spawn. Otherwise, the opponent will try and force the dragon. So it's really important to be prepared for the dragon, especially if it's the Inferno Dragon. Going to do damage. Ooh, he's low life. Maybe we can just jump right there for the Vi. Get the Vi. He's super low life. He went for the dragon. He dies though. Going to poke right here. Let's go for the Sona. He's super low life. Maybe we just flash forward. Auto attack. They're super low life. We want those kills. Let's go. Give me those kills. No, they're both so low. They both survived with like 1% HP. That's so unfortunate. And let's take the mid turret. That's going to be important. We still have one minion. I think we can get the mid turret. Mid turret and then reset. After this big fight, always go reset. I have 2.5k in the bank. Get the gold value from... Oh, can we backport? Yeah, we can. So whenever you win fights and you have a lot of gold, everyone in the team should go backport, get items from the from the fight, and then you have the advantage in items. A lot of times I see people, they have a lot of gold in the inventory, they don't buy items, and then they fight. You basically don't have any advantage because your advantage is still in the inventory. So always, whenever you can, go backport before a fight, get those items, and then you have a power spike and then you can win. For example, right now I should be backporting again because I have Runan's Hurricane and it's a big power spike. Maybe I would just get... Oh, come on, Master Yi, Master Yi! Give me the red buff. Actually, I have red buff, so I don't necessarily need it. But it's going to run out pretty soon. And the ADC and red buff, great synergy! Great synergy! Maybe let it for me. I think I should just backport and get Hurricane right now. Right now, I'm just greedy, to be honest. I should backport it. Oh, he's going to jump in. I don't have flash. Maybe I'm griefing right here. Maybe I'm griefing. I'm trying to run away. Oh my god, I hope I don't die here. I think I might be griefing. Okay, Trindama is going to spawn soon. Let's kill him. Let's go. Okay, let's go for this guy. He's going to die as well. Five people are dead. We should go for Baron. We shouldn't push. I think we should just go for Baron. It's the better call. 10 seconds. Or maybe get one turret and then go for Baron. I think we can get tier 2 and then go for Baron. But tier 3 is too greedy. Okay, let's go for Baron quickly. And after Baron, we will get the next power spike, which is going to be huge. Okay, let's secure it. We got it. Nice. Let's backport. Hopefully, maybe I just go for Guardian Angel. We want the power spike on the third ability, so I would just get for Runan's Hurricane, so I get the invisibility when I use my third ability, so that's pretty neat. Let's shove out the bot wave. looking good so far. Usually you don't want to split push and take three lanes at the same time. Better call is to just focus on two lanes. When you have Baron, most of the times it's better to secure two lanes and push those out. Three at the same time usually doesn't work. I mean, we still can get the tier 2, but getting three tier 3 turrets at the same time is usually not going to work out. It's more safe. Can he? Oh, we didn't hit him. Feels bad, man. Feels bad, man. Safe option, just take two tier 3 turrets and then go for the next Baron and then go for the last tier 3 turret. Safer option. Let's try to hit it. The others are hitting the bot turret. So as you guys can see, we are going to secure two tier 3 turrets instead of just getting one. Because if we do three at the same time, we probably only get one. Okay, doing a lot of damage. And let's go for the mid turret. Okay, we get it as well. Worked out like a charm. We got two tier 3 turrets. Dude, our damage is actually I still have Barrier. I'm going to bait her. Maybe I can kill this girl as well. She's really low life. I think we have to reset right now. Yeah, I don't think we can finish. Let's just go safe option, Guardian Angel, and then try to get the last remaining turret. Exploit their weakness. Like, there's no point. Okay, they're going to FF. So anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this gameplay. I would appreciate if you guys like this video to boost the YouTube algorithm. And see you next time. Bye bye.